Hi, it's Kathy at Art Zone, and I'm here to show you our painting of an Easter egg with patterns throughout the background. Of course, with this painting, along with any of our paintings we do, we always encourage you to come up with your own patterns and own designs. You do not have to follow ours, but I'm here to help you. So, we're going to start by painting the background. In this background, you'll notice that it is multicolor stripes. There's no real pattern to those stripes. I tried to make it kind of Easter-like, choosing bright, colorful colors to fill that background. I'm gonna be painting on paper. If you are painting on canvas, you'll notice the canvas has edges. I always encourage you to paint those edges. Wrap your paint around as you are doing it. In your kit, you should find an egg stencil, a variety of brushes and sponges to do this painting. I would also encourage you to grab a pencil because it might help you plan as we are creating this. The first thing I like to do is to divide my paper up, and you can make as many stripes as you like. So I'm just going to draw a straight line across the middle, and it doesn't have to be perfect. Mine's a little wavy. It will still work just fine. And then I'll come up here, and I think I'm actually going to divide this into thirds. So I'm going to try and make it have three stripes up top. Let's see if you can see that a little better. There's one and two, and they don't have to be perfectly the same size. That's just fine too. And then I'll move down here and I'm going to do the same thing. So I'm going to draw two more stripes. So if you can't see that, I'm going to move this just a little closer. I'm going to rip my paper a little, but that's okay. This is just my example. So there, I started with my middle line. And then I went and I put two lines up top to divide it, and that gave it three stripes up top. And then right down here, I added two more stripes for a total of six stripes for myself. Wait. Yeah. And then we'll put that right back up here.
And we're ready to start painting. You can choose any color that you want with your stripes.
I'm going to start my stripe with my light blue. I'm going to take my big brush, load it up, and that very first stripe, I'm going to make light blue. I like to take my paint all the way across. Like I said, if you're painting on canvas, make sure and take that paint and wrap it around the edge and get your top edge so that it's all painted in. But spread that paint out. We are using an acrylic paint. Our acrylic paint, I'm going to go ahead and clean out my paintbrush. Our acrylic paint is a little thin, so I always encourage everybody to do at least two layers to make it really cover up. This first layer is usually kind of light. Once I've cleaned my brush, I also want to dry it with a towel or a paper towel. Be nice to your brush as you're drying it.
I think my next stripe,
I'm gonna go orange. Of course, you decide what you want. You don't have to follow my colors. Now we are gonna have to be careful and try not to mix into our blue, but it is okay if it does get a little blue mixed in. It's not gonna hurt anything.
I usually just go back and forth and
mix it some. Take your time.
You could also let it dry
before you add that orange stripe, and then it wouldn't mix with your orange and you wouldn't have that problem.
And
you're just going to keep going until you've filled in all your stripes. If you wanted to do a pattern, of course you could do that.
Or you could simply
make it random. Random meaning it doesn't have a pattern. And this time I'm going for my light green. Try and go slow when I'm next to that orange so I can get more of a straight line in between the two.
Nice and crisp.
To do this painting along with our story time for Pete the Cat's great
Easter adventure. Going on to my dark blue. Is trying to mix into that blue, and it's okay. I'm not too worried about that.
You could even make these wavy if you
wanted to. Switch it up some.
I'm gonna go pink
on this one. If I'm painting too fast, that's okay. You can always stop the video, pause the video. One more stripe to fill in before I do my second layer. I think this next stripe,
I'm going to go purple. You can see I'm already doing it different than my original one. I've switched my colors up.
You're going to want to let this dry before you go and add a second layer of the same color. So once again, I'll add that light blue and I'll go orange. I'll clean out my paintbrush in between all my colors. You're going to want it to dry about 10 to 15 minutes before you add that second coat on. That way, if I just keep adding paint on this right now, it's just going to cause the acrylic paint to start coming off and showing even more streaks than it does in that first layer. You can use a blow dryer, but if you use a blow dryer, you want it to be on low, and you don't want it to be very close to your painting. You want it to be kind of far away. But the easiest thing is just to walk away and come back in 10 and 15 minutes, do your second layer, and then once again, you're gonna have to let it dry before we can continue on. Now, I've already done that. I actually have a whole new paper right over here that has already had a second coat put on, and it has already dried. So I'm actually just going to tape it right on top of that so that I can keep showing you how I completed my painting down here. The next step, I'm going to use my stencil for just a moment. I'm not going to use my white yet. I'm going to use a pencil again, but I'm going to take that stencil. And I'm going to decide where I want my egg, if I want it right in the middle, or maybe you want to put it to the side and you want to add some words or something around your egg. You have to think about what you're going to do to your painting. Since it is yours, you can do it different. But I'm going to stick with my original, where it's just an egg right in the middle. I'm going to take my pencil and I'm going to draw or trace where my egg is going. I'm not painting it in yet. The reason that I'm drawing this right now is I don't need to add all my patterns in the middle of the egg because they're harder to cover up than my stripes are. So I'm not going to add patterns inside the egg. I'll add patterns in the stripes around the egg. So now I can take that stencil, put it to the side, and I am ready to start on my patterns. Now, first, you can see some of the patterns are more designs and they fill in the space, and then some of them can be more of your traditional patterns, like if you think blue circle, yellow circle, blue circle, yellow circle. Patterns have to repeat. Each stripe has its own design to fill in. You can draw them with a pencil and then paint on top of them, or you can go for it with your paintbrush and your sponges. You can see these circles, they were added with our sponges. If you look real close, you'll see there's a green circle and then there's a yellow circle inside. I'll show you how we did that. And then even down here, you can see there's this blue circle and then there's a really small pink circle inside. Okay, I'm not gonna draw my patterns out. I'm just gonna grab my paintbrushes and my sponges and I'm gonna start adding them. For my first stripe, I'm gonna use my big sponge and I'm going to make a pattern of purple and yellow. I'm gonna make a pattern of purple and yellow circles. To do that, I'm gonna take this sponge and I'm gonna get some paint on it. I don't want a bunch of paint on this sponge. So all these spots right there, see how little globby it is? I don't want that. So I can keep tapping around. If I had a piece of paper here, I could tap on it to kind of spread that paint out before I go to make my dots. So I'm gonna make a purple dot here. I don't wanna push too hard, otherwise it won't be a dot. Sometimes it turns into a different shape. And then I'm gonna make a yellow dot. And I'm gonna use the back of the paintbrush to actually use this sponge. I'm gonna use the back of it to actually make the yellow. So once again, I get some yellow on, but look, there's too much. So now I have to tap around here, get some of that off, and now I can make my yellow dot. And then I'll go back to my purple. So my pattern will be yellow, purple, yellow, purple, all the way across this top. Now we can come back and we can add more patterns inside these later when they dry. We always have to let things dry before we add more. If your dauber is not filling it in perfectly, well, I can come back with a paintbrush and fix that later too. And now I have to decide if I could fit one more, and I think I can. It might come real close to that yellow dot, but I think I can fit it in. And there's my first pattern. Purple, yellow, purple, yellow, purple, yellow, purple. And I can come back later. Now I'm gonna go ahead and let those circles dry before I add any more to them. And I'm gonna clean out my paint dauber. My next pattern, I'm gonna use my paintbrush for. I'm gonna use my smaller paintbrush. And I'm gonna stay with one color for this pattern. I think I'm gonna do a line pattern. I'm gonna use pink for it.
And maybe I'll go
straight line.
Uh-oh, my egg's gonna be in my way. Remember, I don't wanna do patterns inside my egg, I wanna do them around it.
So right here should be a zigzag, and I'll do it as much as I can before the egg covers it up, and that's okay. And then I'll come up here, and I can do just a little bit of a straight line.
And then skip over to the side, and I'll do
a little bit of a zigzag. Several more lines to fill in with different kinds of patterns and different colors, anything that you choose.
I actually already
have this step done, and I'm going to show you
right here.
You can kind of see where my egg is right here,
where I've drawn,
and you see all the different patterns that I chose to do. So I went down, and I can, now that these patterns have all dried, I can go back and I can make them even more interesting. So I'm gonna tape this one up.
to my circles that were up here, and I'm going to do a color inside of each one. So this purple circle, a light color would look really good inside of it. I think I'll go with an orange. So I'm going to take my dauber, and I'm actually using my smaller dauber for this one, and I'm going to give each of my purple circles, I'm going to give them orange inside. So now my pattern gets a little more complicated. And I could let those dry, and then I could use the back of my dauber to get an even smaller circle and add them in. Or maybe I'll take dark blue and add a real tiny dark blue into each of my yellows. For my lines, remember I did pink and I did straight line, zigzag, straight line, zigzag. I could still add more interest to them if I take my paintbrush. I used it just a few minutes ago, so I'm going to clean it and dry it off. But maybe I'll take some yellow. And on my straight lines, I'm going to add little bitty straight lines. And I'll bring this closer to you in just a moment so you can see. They don't have to be perfect. Zigzag line. Maybe I'll add some dots into it. So this painting can be a lot of fun with a lot of different patterns. So now I'm going to take that same color and I'm going to add dots into my zigzag line. And I'm just barely touching tiny little dots. I hope you'll share some of your paintings with us. Send them to us at Art Zone, some pictures, so that we can see what you guys have done. Closer to you, so you can see what I've done. See how I added more interest to those top rows? Now I still have all these patterns down there that I could add more to, but I'm going to let you guys do that. And I'm going to move on to showing you how to finish the egg. So I'm going to take this back up here. Let your paper dry all the way, your painting, before you actually use your stencil again. I'm going to go ahead and take this stencil and I'm going to line it up with the egg. My egg's right here. Now tape it down. To get the egg on there, once again, you're going to want one of your sponges, your daubers. If they are wet, you're going to want to dry them off, clean them out really, really well, since we're going to be using white. You're going to want to take it after it's been cleaned and really get that water out of it. And take some of that white paint. Remember, we don't want globs. Tap it around, get some of that white off. Hold your stencil down and then slowly dab it in. Now, sometimes the white will cover up all of your stripes real easily, and then sometimes it might take doing this more than once to get that white to cover up. That's okay. Remember, you have to let the paint dry before you do a second layer. You do not want to leave your stencil on while that paint is drying.
then your stencil might dry to your painting and it will rip your painting, and you don't want that.
Or it'll rip the stencil and leave stencil on your painting.
So go real slow.
Don't push hard on the dauber.
Now we can make this
texture. You see it? I don't know if you can tell, but sometimes when you're using daubers, it looks a little textured. We can make that go away once it dries by painting over it with white and using a paintbrush.
So when you take this off,
your stencils are reusable, so you'll want to set those to the side, let them dry before you do anything else to your painting. But have fun, create lots of patterns, and we look forward to creating with you again at Art Zone.